with our series Takeout Fakeout, where we recreate some of the most popular meals from the top food delivery apps across the country. Chef Jeff Mauro. Hey, what's up, man? Jeff is the host of Food Network's The Kitchen, and he is here now to show us his take on barbecue. So let's bring out the first delivery. Here comes our delivery man.
My favorite sound.
My favorite sound. And Maria, Maria's gonna help us out. So Maria, what kind of takeout do we have today?
Barbecue pork.
Barbecue pork. And what is our second delivery?
Oh my goodness. Buttermilk chicken?
Yeah. Buttermilk chicken. Oh, let's do this, man.
Let's do it.
All right, we're going to the kitchen. Now, according to the app Seamless, these are two of the top 10 foods that people order over the summer. So we're going to start with the buttermilk fried chicken.
Fried chicken. People love fried chicken. They love it brought to their house. They don't want to stink up your chicken, but it can be a little cumbersome, a little hard to do.
And it seems like this would take a lot of time. So what are some of the things we can do and prep to make this go a little bit quicker?
Starting with what kind of chicken we're using. Instead of using big bone-in chicken, pieces of chicken, we're going to use boneless, skinless breast. Cooks much faster, much more evenly, I know. But we're not just going to bread it and fry it. No, we're going to brine it first in pickle juice. This is pickle brine. Helps bring out a lot of flavor, impart a lot of flavor, and make it super tender. So then we're going to go right into that buttermilk and egg mixture to kind of make this the glue, hence the buttermilk.
The glue, yeah.
And this is not any kind of breading. This is a mixture of almond flour, Parmesan cheese,
Why
and Italians.
Flour?
So if you're following like a keto diet or a gluten-free diet or a grain-free diet, this is much healthier. Now you can definitely fry this in hot oil, get it crispy, beautiful. I have a version right there. Or you just put it on a wire rack baking sheet
and
cook it for about 30, 40 minutes at 350. Comes out perfect.
And that's what you end up with.
And then, but how do we make it a little bit indulgent, right, Michael?
Jazz it up.
This is butter, hot sauce, and maple syrup.
Ooh.
And then we're gonna drizzle that, give it kind of a wing vibe, plus a buttery, hot heat vibe, and I'll put a little bit of that on there. And that's easy to do. This cooks up in 30 minutes. If you do it on the pan fry method, you're done in 15 minutes.
Yeah.
You're done.
A little healthier, too. Bacon.
Boom. Less mess.
And we have some audience members, though, who are back there, and they're trying. So what do you think so far?
Looks great.
Looks great. What are you doing? I didn't come here to say it looked good. I know we look great.
Nothing like buttermilk fried chicken
Amen
for breakfast.
All right, now we're going to do pulled pork, right? Barbecue pork, starting with a big shoulder.
Yeah.
You got to smoke it for 14 hours. Who's got that time, Michael? Me and you were both athletes, right?
Yeah.
Not me. More of a, by athlete, I mean I did high school theater. So what we do is rub some, these are blade pork chops, right? Ask your butcher for them. It's like a smaller version of a pork shoulder. A lot of fat. We're going to rub it. It's going into a pan that we rendered some bacon fat in there, right? We're going to sear it up, crisp it up.
Okay.
That bacon fat's going to give our smoky element. Here we have it. Now we got it ready to go in a little Pyrex dish here. Pour our favorite barbecue sauce.
Okay.
Why don't you, this to help thin it out. And we're going to bake it.
And we're going to bake it for how long?
No smoker, no grill. You do this all inside until it gets fork tender, about, 2 hours or so. And what you're left with is the same mouthfeel, the same flavor, the same sweetness and smokiness you would in barbecue pulled pork, but easier done. I saved you I saved you 13 hours.
13 hours.
What are you going to pay me now?
I don't know. We'll work out together.
We'll do it with the workout. But if you need another option and you don't want to do the bun and the slaw, which is my favorite preparation, if you want to even go even healthier, serve it with some grilled vegetables. We got some zucchini, some summer squash, some spinach, that way you can eat as much as you want and not have all the starch and the bread.
You've just made me extremely hungry right now. Jeff, thank you so much, man. Appreciate you. Now, that's the way you do barbecue. You can get all these recipes on our website. If you want to know what dishes you'd like us to make next, so go to our We Are GMA Facebook group to weigh in, and we're going to try to make those for you.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.